Hey, what's up, HTC? It's your host, Michael Okwesene, kicking it at HTC's Ybor City Studios. Welcome to the first edition of Hawk Nation, HTC's first online entertainment show. So, you may be asking yourself, what is Hawk Nation? Hawk Nation is a showcase of HTC's finest, from students and activities to entertainment and venues around our five campuses. We have a lot to show you this edition, so let's get to it. Get your beads and pirate hats ready, because we're going to take you for a ride at Gasparilla's Day Parade. Forget parrots, these pirate ships are about to see some hawks. HTC represented at all three Gasparilla parades this season. Time to take you aboard the HTC float.
Happy Gasparilla!
How long have you been coming to Gasparilla?
50 years.
Wow. How's it changed since?
It's not downtown, it's old downtown anymore. It's on Bayshore now. And a lot more floats, a lot more of everything. Just a blew up.
I have been doing the parade probably for about 15 years. It's getting larger and larger, more crews, but it's a lot of fun. We love it.
How long has SDA been in Gasparilla? Oh, we've been in it for years. This is my first time participating this year with the campus, but it's going to be fun. So, have you ever been on the Gasparilla float before?
Yes, I was on it last year in the Ybor Parade. It's really fun. It's my favorite thing, being an SGA, just to experience and go out in the community and have fun.
Nation's Erica Rodriguez. Hope you enjoyed Gasparilla 2016. I did.
That looked like a lot of fun. Well, we all could use some extra cash for school, right? What if I told you you could run for it? HC is having its first ever Hawk Run. Check this out.
Hi, I'm Erica Rodriguez, and we're here with Dr. Earl Paul from HTC's Brandon campus. Thanks for coming.
Thank you, Erica. Glad to be here.
Let's talk about this Hawk Run. What's it about?
Well, it's the first time we've ever tried doing this. We have a club that started it called AMSA, American Medical Student Association. They're into health and wellness, and they thought, well, let's do something that will benefit the students as well as the faculty, staff, and the public. So we've opened it up to the public as well. Well,
great. How do you register for this Hawk Run?
Well, we basically have an online site, getmeregistered.com/HCCHawk5K. You can go on there and register. The cost of the registration is $20, so it's actually
okay.
A very low registration. We did that on purpose because we know a lot of students want to run in this, and we know that,
it's going to
be, we know what the budgets are like. It's also a run that is sanctioned, which is real important.
Mm-hmm.
It's a chip race, meaning that the timing, there's a chip that each person will get. It will be a timed race.
Oh.
It's a sanctioned race, so if people are trying to get races in, this is one they can do. They've had the course marked off by a professional, and it is one that they can do and get credit for.
And what is this for? Is the money going towards any kind of benefits?
The money's going to the HCC Foundation. So this will be for
student
scholarships in the future.
Mm-hmm.
And so we're trying to, again, think about the students because that's what we are.
Yes.
We are a student, we're a college, and we want to try to help some students. So the money goes back to a good cause. And we're really, like I said, we're asking for $20 registration. That goes for anybody that registers will get a t-shirt,
mm-hmm.
they'll get a medal, a completion medal. So they also get some bennies for being involved in this race as well.
Oh, that's cool. Where will it be held?
It's going to be at the HCC Brandon site off of Falkenberg and Columbus.
Hmm.
It'll be held on February Saturday, the 27th. We'll start our first run at 8 a.m. The second It's the 5K walk run, so mm-hmm. you don't have to run it all. If you don't want to, you can walk it as well, mm-hmm. or run walk. And then we have a 1 mile walk run beginning at 8:45.
What else is going on?
Well, I want people to know that we also have some vendors out there. We'll have the Florida Blood Mobile out there doing blood draws if people want to do that. That'll be going on from 8 o'clock to 10 o'clock. We have George's Hot Dogs, so people that want to eat something, if they're just there with somebody and they want to watch, but they just want to grab something to eat, they can do that. We have the Diabetes Association. We have Smoothie King out there giving away free samples, and a couple of other vendors. So we have a number of things will be going on for the racers as well as people that are there for the actual event.
That's cool. Any awards?
Yeah, we do have some awards. We got some great things for people. We have prizes for non-students, first, second, and third place. Mm-hmm. We also have the Masters, which is over 65. We have first, second, and third place prizes for that. And then for students, for males and females, the first, second, and third place in both categories will be getting book scholarships through the HCC, through HCC. And this is all sponsored. One of the main sponsors is also HCC Brandon SGA, and they're providing a lot of these kinds of things. The foundation, of course, is a sponsor. HCC is a sponsor. AMSA, the one I mentioned, American Medical Student Association, is a sponsor. But the students will get the first place in both male and female will get $250 book scholarships.
Wow.
Second place will get $100 book scholarships, and third place for each will get $75 scholarships. So we're trying to make this an all-encompassing kind of event. We also have a health and wellness poster contest.
Oh, wow.
And we have a health and wellness fine arts contest. And they need to go to HCCAMSA.com mm-hmm. to look at the details for those as well.
Okay. Thank you so much. Thanks for taking time out to talk to us about
this. Erica, thank you.
Thank you. I'm Erica Rodriguez. Back to you guys in the studio.
I don't know about you, but I'm ready to get my running shoes on now. We wish all the ACC runners the best. We have a lot more fun and entertainment coming up on Hawk Nation. Don't go away. We'll be right back with a special performance.
I love to cook. I like working with my hands. I love eating. And I've cooked at home but never in a restaurant. So this is my opportunity to do something new. I love it.
The way that we have it set up, you could come in here, have absolutely no skill. We'll teach you that skill. Also, we have some really interesting internship programs for our students. It gives the students both the academic and it also gives them the experience they need. Students will either be earning an associate in science, in culinary management, in restaurant management, or in hospitality and tourism management.
I always wanted to be in the kitchen, and I always liked sweets. I have a sweet tooth. I just felt like I'm in the right place at the right time.
The great thing about HEC was it wasn't a full, I got to commit for 2 years, I got to pay all up front. So it's easy to dip into if you're still working a regular job. In fact, most people here are working either a full or part-time job. It's a great opportunity, and then if you like it, you can go on the program, and you can do a full load, 5 classes a semester, or you can go 1 and 2 and take 2 or 3 years while you're working.
It is state-of-the-art equipment, and the thing with our industry with technology is that every single year it changes. We are very fortunate that the college does support us every single year.
There was so much equipment, and I got a little bit overwhelmed, but once you learn where everything is, you will feel like it's your home.
The equipment is great. I used the elevated grill, and I cooked 80 pieces of chicken at one time. I can't do that at home. There's 5 stoves. It is fantastic. I don't want to leave.
These teachers, they want you to learn and they want you to succeed, and that's what you really feel, and you really connect with them.
We learn so much, and the chefs are so passionate here.
They're really interested in food. It's awesome. It's the best thing you could possibly do. It's really, really fun.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the HCC Jazz Band, under the direction of Robert Winslow, featuring Velmont Miller, One in a Million.
The digital television and media production program here is a very intense hands-on training program. We pride ourselves in teaching our students what it's really like to be out there in the field.
There's absolutely a passion here at HTC. Because it's so hands-on, we all just love what we do, and the teachers help us to just fall in love even more with what we want to do.
I found that this department here is different because they offer more real hands-on experience and real-life skills that we can take from school directly to work.
Students here are learning everything from behind the scenes, in front of the camera. They're learning to be talent. They're having their own radio shows. They have their own TV shows. They're out there like TV crews producing commercial video, news pieces, film projects, you name it.
The faculty here is second to none. I believe they have years of industry experience. They have helped students get internships and full-time positions at well-known media entertainment companies around Florida. And also they have given us industry references that we can call upon after graduation.
The whole goal is to put your resume together, put your portfolio together, get the internship, make the connections, get out in the field, and get a job.
I'm interning right now at daytime with Channel 8. I never thought I'd be working at a television studio while still in college. It was kind of like an aha moment, like, yeah, this is what I want to do. This is awesome.
We have the TV studio, we have the radio studio, we have the camera equipment. So what we want to do is get our students out there with the equipment working so they can produce their reels.
I have been involved right from the pre-production to the script writing, to the post-production, to the editing. I'm very grateful to be a part of this television film community.
If you like to create, if you like to tell stories, if you like to produce something and actually see results, come to the Digital Television Media Production Program. You will be so amazed at what you can do.
You're never gonna find another program like this. It's fun, it's very hands-on, and you're gonna make some lifelong friends.
Hey guys, welcome back. You know, ACC's got talent, a lot of talent on campus. So much talent, Hawk Nation wants to show it off. So in tonight's HCC's Got Talent segment, we introduce you to HCC student Cece Ivy. Take it away, Cece.
Centuries, I wish for you, didn't you drink for me? Enter through my heart, you tore apart. Pretty pain, squish, scream, addictive, fanatic scar. Do what you wanna do all the time. I allow it. Broken heart won't hear me out. Eminence, time to save it. Daughter won't scribe, even man strung out. Undo love and this past play. Well, I saw who's touch connection 100. I to the stars, touchdown, gotta go. Wanna be the girl next door. Seeing up a phone, a call, a text, I like blinking forever. Crazy to have feelings for those who put you in a trance and don't even notice. Those lives in your heart, honey, from the start and the live it all up in my mind. All up in mind. Too much love. When you speak a quiver, thoughts of that bass, it's really innocence. Makes no sense to change nightmares. Kiss and tell me night secrets. The dreaming in darkness, inception to kill. Body of a titan, pure poison and adult bleeding love. One bottle left, now I'm broken. Meaning, what must I want was not needed. Sweet nothing. Or should I trust my intuition? Or is this all in my mind? Too much love for one life. unreal, but so real. All in my mind. Feels like centuries. I wish for your dead to drain me. Enter through my heart, you tore apart. Pretty pain, scream, scream, addictive, and out of disguise. Do what you wanna do. All the time. I allow it. All in my mind, all in my mind. Too much love, love, love for one like you. I want what I want, no good, but I know it's so good. All in my mind, all in my mind.
That was beautiful, CC. You know, I've got some talent myself. Yeah, yeah, yeah. All right, let's forget that. Hey, if you have a talent, Hawk Nation wants to show it off. Come down to our Hawk Studios and audition for us. You may get on the show. Okay, so now that we've had a little entertainment, I'm getting hungry. College students are always hungry. And what's the number one college food? Pizza. Here's a place you might want to check out the next time you get a craving for a good slice. I'm Hawk Nation's Michael Ocorsene here at Mellow Mushrooms, and I'm here with Justin Newsom, and he's going to show us how to make the perfect pie. What entails when you're making pizza? Like, what do you have to do?
Well, first you got to make sure that your dough is properly proofed. If it's underproofed, you're going to end up having a hard time stretching it. If it's overproofed, you're going to have too easy of a time stretching it. You want to make sure you have that nice, even kilter for the dough. That way it cooks properly, it browns properly, and it spreads out and rises properly.
Okay.
The first step in forming your pizza is making sure you have a nice crust definition. Now, you start round, usually end round, so it's always nice to keep your shape, make sure that you have everything appropriate and proportionate. Keep all your crust the same, about an inch thick around, and then we toss it. Let's step back.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Boy, look at him go. Like a born natural.
We use cornmeal instead of normal flour. It allows the pies to slide off our peel. They don't get stuck. It allows them to keep their shape too while we're putting it in the oven. When we bake our pies, we bake them in a 500 degree stone earth-based oven. It's a classic pizza oven. It's been a company for well over 100 years. It's been a pizza standard since, we're going to say 1924.
Wow. Since 1924.
Possibly. I don't know. Yeah. I just made that up.
But you're keeping the tradition strong, so.
Pretty much.
So I guess now you're just saucing it up and adding it on?
Depending on what pie you order, traditionally our pizzas have a red sauce base. But we also offer oil and garlic as well as a pesto.
So I think now, Justin, we're just gonna watch you make some magic. I'm Michael Ocorsene. This is Justin Newsom.
Hi, Mom.
And that's how you make a pizza at Mellow Mushrooms. And we'll be back at Hawk Nation. There are a few Mellow Mushrooms in the Tampa Bay area. Definitely a cool place for good pizza. From pizza to Cubans, we have more cool eats for HEC students. When in Ybor, check out the Stone Soup Company. Hawk Nation checked it out and found there's more than good soup there.
Hi, I'm Ethan Walther from HEC's Hawk Nation, coming to you from the Stone Company in Ybor. And we're here with Ilya Goldberg, the manager. What do we have today?
We have here today an Ybor City Cuban sandwich that's been made for about 100 years. We perfected it. and we won about three different competitions 3 years in a row. And we made a Spanish bean smoked sausage soup as well. Especially for you guys, it's a new item. It's probably going to be put into the menu here in the next week or two. The Ybor, a Spanish bean soup, is very much a Puerto Rican, Cuban kind of Latin kind of thing. So we decided to put our little spin on it and create that for all of our customers.
Now, what is the difference between a regular Cuban and an Ybor City Cuban?
Well, they make Cuban sandwiches all over the country because they copy us. They make Cuban sandwiches in Miami. The difference in Tampa is it's made on Tampa Cuban bread. It's made with ham, roasted pork, salami, that's key, because we had a lot of Italian immigrants here back in the day, so they added salami. We're the only ones that add salami. Swiss cheese, pickles, mustard. We do a mayo mustard just to make it a little bit easier to eat, so it's not as spicy or not as strong. We also cut our Cubans differently. Most people cut it at an angle. We cut it long ways so it can be dipped, and it can be a little bit easier to dip.
From the Stone Soup Company in Ybor City, I'm Ethan Walther. Now back to the studio.
Thanks, guys. Hawk Nation is not done yet. Stay tuned.
My name's Kara Reese. I'm in the paramedic program. Originally, I wanted to be a police officer, but I decided the EMT program would be a good way to supplement that career field, and I love it so far. It's a lot of fun.
Here at the campus, my paramedic students are here for 3 semesters. Over that time period, they're going to go through 12 to 16 weeks of trauma skills, medical skills, EKG, advanced cardiac life support, as well as pediatric advanced life support scenarios and treatments. Most of my medic students, they're usually already had some type of college experience because they have to go through EMTs first, which is a 12 to 16 week program. And then after that, then they'll sign up for the year program through paramedic.
In the lab, we do everything from the assessments to what we'll break it down into individual skills as far as like intubations or some of the more exciting things, and backboarding is one of the more repetitive things.
We do a lot of scenarios so you can get from the beginning to the end of how to treat a patient. You get a little nervous, but the more you do it, obviously, the easier it gets.
The teachers really bring the field experience, the outside-the-box thinking, not just being a cookbook medic and going by the book, but actually paying attention to your patient and treating your patient.
We try to keep the technology the same to the different departments in the area so that students have a good feel, just in case there's an interagency response that they're very familiar with their equipment.
I mean, anything you need out in the real world, they have it in this classroom, and that's great. We actually do have 3 separate ambulances set up, and we have all the equipment that you really need on an ambulance.
We do a lot of out-in-the-field clinicals. We work with the fire departments, so you get to ride out on the rescues in the field. You gotta be willing to put yourself out there, get in the middle of things, and that graduation, it's gonna be awesome. I'd be a certified paramedic, be able to go out in the field and actually help people.
Ladies and gentlemen, the HCC Chorus, led by Ms. Ruthie Nelson, accompanied by Emmy Stefanoff.
Oh,
Hi, my name is Jennifer Older. I am in the Nuclear Medicine Technology Program. What attracted me to nuclear medicine was the fact that the technology was so advanced and you got to work with people.
Nuclear medicine and molecular imaging is under the umbrella of radiology. We use radioactive isotopes to diagnose, stage, and treat different medical disorders and diseases. Nuclear medicine tends to be a fusion of physics, biology, and chemistry. So students usually that are good in math and science do well in the program.
When I graduate, I will have a degree in nuclear medicine technology with an associate's of science.
The program takes 2 years to complete.
Through the 2 years, you are complete hands-on, because not only do you learn here in the classroom, but you also learn at your clinical setting.
Students do enjoy their clinical rotations a lot. That's where they really get to apply everything that they've learned in the classroom.
The first time I actually worked with a patient in a hospital setting, it was scary, but I felt confident because I had worked so hard here in the lab.
I love it. The facility's great. The lab is great. You know, everything hands-on. The teacher's really good. I think we're very well prepared for the future.
We actually received over $100,000 in grants that we were able to apply to our lab.
The state-of-the-art equipment that is in our lab is actually what I am working with. I realized I made the right decision with my program the day I walked into clinicals. It was just so exciting. I went home totally pumped and excited about what I was going to be doing as a new career path.
Did we all have a good time? Well, that's it for us here at Hawk Nation. Hope you enjoyed the show. Check back with us next time. I'm your host, Michael Okwesene, and on behalf of our Hawk Nation crew and correspondents, I'll leave you with this. Stay fly, Hawks. Yeah!